Hey, is it live? Are we live? Is this really happening? What's up, Snarf? The Zoltan in the house. How you doing? Viking Kate, too? Y'all are animals. What's up, Cyrus Black? Thanks for coming in. Good to see you. It's finally starting. I know we had people in the lobby breaking down the door before we even went live. I appreciate you being here. Viking raiding the chat. Crack mother, good to see you downstairs hanging out. I think Santa was around. I appreciate you all, and I appreciate our guests for coming back and doing the show now that we have a show again. It's a show. It's a thing I'm doing with guests. Look at that. Theremin Player and Athena Sleeps In. What's up, Santa? What's up, Theremin Player?
How's it going? Hey.
In the
Hi,
flesh.
Guys.
The new
in the
flesh.
In the flesh.
Yeah.
Or in space.
Yes. Space flesh. You're used to being in space, right?
Oh, yeah. Yes.
All
yes,
the time,
I am.
Right?
Yes. Yes, I am.
We have someone else hanging out somewhere around here. Is it Athena Sleeps In? What's up, Athena?
Hi.
Hi. Welcome to the show.
I'm going to get zapped tonight. I don't like it.
Well, that's assuming a lot. That's assuming people want to cheer bits. But you can cheer bits and zap Athena if you want
please
to.
Please don't zap me.
she says, please don't zap. You can zap Brack. I mean, you know, that's a thing, too. Hey, thank you so much for being here, both of you. We had some technical issues. We're back. That's what streamers do, right? We fall apart and then we bounce back, right?
Yeah.
But one step backwards, two step forward. Is that how it goes?
Chumbawamba.
No, yep.
I get knocked down, but I get up
get
again.
Get up again.
Yep.
Never gonna keep me down.
Yeah.
Yep. No. So, blah, gra, blarg. Says
hi,
Zap Vibes.
Hi. Hi. Blah.
Good to see you. Thanks for being here.
You all about to practice to be able to say that name that fast?
Yeah. Blah, gra, blarg. Blah, gra, blarg.
Blah, blarg.
It's like blah, Mars Attack. Blarg, blarg, blarg.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
So what would you normally be doing on a Friday night, Theremin Player?
Probably
is this
just
a normal thing for you?
I stream, you know. I don't know. Usually I just fly around on my spaceship and travel around the
cosmic
space.
Cosmic rays out. Yeah.
Yeah. And I always find space whales and stuff. And
space whales. I think I heard you say on your stream, Theremin Player streams. They stream Theremin. I don't know if you knew that, but I heard you once say it's like a space cello. Isn't that right?
Yeah, actually,
yes,
I think
it is a space cello. That's so good.
Yeah, I think someone actually said that back in the day, back when the theremin in the 20s. I'm pretty sure someone, there's a quote somewhere on the internet that someone said that back in the 20s. So, yeah.
Mr. Theremin. Theremin. No, yeah. Is it really? There we go. And so Athena Sleeps In streams as well.
Sometimes.
I've heard. Sometimes.
Occasionally, yes.
It's been a thing that you enjoy doing sometimes, occasionally.
Sometimes I enjoy it. Sometimes it's like torture.
Right.
Right.
How would you describe your stream?
My stream keeps evolving like a Pokemon. So the concept is, oh, my cat's here.
Yay.
Hold on, real quick.
Yeah.
Everyone, this is teacup.
That is a
oh my
big
gosh.
Cat.
Yeah, he's big.
Big teacup. What a
he likes
cat.
To be part of the show.
I love cats.
He has terrible allergies.
What's up, Swims? Your cat has allergies? Is your cat allergic?
Yeah, he's
to
allergic
humans?
To everything. I have to cook him beef from scratch.
It's fancy.
That's dedication.
I fear,
though, that's a lot more normal at this point, is preparing your animal's food. That's a thing I mean, I know you know that, but yeah, it's like a lot more common to be like making your own food. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's what I do on my stream. No. So concept originally was to do typewriter poetry requests. So yes. I don't know if you guys have ever been like to New Orleans or like it happens all over the place. You see someone on the street with a typewriter typing poems by request. So that was the original concept.
I see that all the time.
Like just the last stream I did,
tripping over.
I drew this.
Yes, like a
this. This nice. Is Mark Shrek.
Yes.
I met him in my dreams. He was in a Christmas musical. And I was watching it on YouTube. So
Dark Shrek.
That's what I do now.
What's up, Apollo Koala? I love that. And so but poetry. That must be like pretty
poetry.
Challenging to like write on stream. Right, like
it is.
There's a lot of creative stuff going on stream, but like writing is its whole own. It's very brain intensive. Like, right, it takes a lot of concentration.
Yeah. And then people
are coming in. You got to chat with them or not. I mean,
well, actually, so the typewriter requests are easy because I write for a living, so I can just bang those out in about 5 minutes. Especially if I take some time to go on Wikipedia beforehand, which is usually most of the stream. But I also do live writing with handwriting, and I collaborate with musicians sometimes. So like Aaron Goldberg, if you know him, or the Graceful Bard and Mind of a Snail, who they're not on Twitch much anymore.
I know, that is real
intense, but the music definitely helps me like get into the zone.
That's real streaming, you know what I'm saying? No, so you collaborate with musicians like Theremin Player, right? I mean, you haven't in the past, but
I've never done a reading before, so this is exciting. I have a guilty of having a history of doing slam poetry in Chicago.
Guilty and, is charged.
Yeah, often with a jazz band. So
I was just gonna ask, have you done slam poetry in Chicago with a jazz band? That was my next question.
I'm guilty as charged.
And so what's up, Momo Draws Sweet Tea and Spaps.
Hi, Momo.
I want to say hi to Spaps.
Hi,
Spaps.
But thanks for being here, everyone. They're all here for you, Athena. Yep. and this guy. So what do you two think? Should we try something out? Should we do a theremin and poetry thing? It's like, I feel like that's a lot of art to be contained within this one show. I don't know if I can handle it. I don't know if my head's going to explode or something's going to explode.
Heck yeah. Who's got the heck yeah? Swims with whales.
Swims with whales.
At TH.
Perfect for this. What's up, Swims? I'm gonna leave it in your very capable hands. Theremin Player, do you want to start us off?
Is there a vibe we're going for at all, or just
I should probably explain. You guys already know. I should probably explain to the chat.
Intro us
that. So I tease that I'm gonna be reading from a new poetry manuscript. These are all poems that I wrote with predictive text on my phone.
I understand now. I get it.
Thank you. They're weird. They're often weird, though.
No, we don't do weird here. This is all very normal.
Never.
Only do normal things here.
Only. Yeah, this is a very normal stream. Hey, Pants O'Clock.
Hey, Pants.
And Nox Moderato.
Hey, Pants.
Nox.
There's so many friends in the chat.
Yeah. And Bad Phone Chad unlocked the 1K bits badge. What the hell?
Oh, yeah.
We appreciate that. Yeah, that's awesome. So cool.
Good phone, Chad.
I don't even I'm going to have to change your name now. What's up, Tech? Let's get into it. And again, Mr. Player.
Mr. Theremin
Player. Would you be okay with starting us off? And then
okay,
Athena can come in when she pleases. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Ready?
Ready.
I'm ready.
Okay.
Ready.
Ode to the beginning. First, a series of stories. Tell me about your favorite movie, or what you think about the lyrics to the song you wrote. What do they mean when they say the end result is a beautiful moment? I, for one, am not going to lie. The fact is, it has to be a very special occasion, or else I won't wear my watch. It will never tell me what time I should leave. It only shows the date of your last visit. I'm trying my luck at the grocery store. The only thing I can find is a small bag of frozen fruit. The fruit is not a good substitute for your regular apple. It is not a problem to make a pie, but it will take time to eat it all. It will take years for me to forget about the things I've done for you. But starting off, I'm going back to the original question. Why did you choose to be the one who wants my attention? I'm not a huge believer of any sort of meditation, but I can't think about anything else other than your name and your address. I'm sure you can find someone else to be your mom. For now, we will continue without any further discussion of the issue of how to proceed. Moving forward, I'm going to be your best new customer. I'm buying a new method for being anonymous. Ode to what's unsaid. I made friends with a woman who wants to be a doctor. She says she's going to do a new type of surgery. First, a knife was used to remove an explosive device. Now, she will use it to help you understand how you feel. When I was younger, my dad would throw a baseball and I would throw a tantrum. I would cry if my husband didn't give me a kiss on the forehead. He said he was in the process of becoming an ambassador to the United States of real life. But he was not a good actor. I could tell he had a very sharp eye for the ball, but he didn't know how to get it. I held out my hand, and then I heard a loud noise. It was so loud, I couldn't hear anything other than the voice in my head. It said I was going to become a good citizen. It was a very interesting conversation. I'm not sure if it's the truth. Ode to quitting. Your mind is a very important thing, but your brain has a tendency towards thinking about the consequences. A skilled person will not be a good fit for a career in this industry. The industry is in need of new talent. The talent will come from a variety of different fields, such as manufacturing and marketing and marketing and manufacturing. The fields are expected to grow. The first round of negotiations will begin in a few days. I'm still working on my final draft. It's about a year spent in the office with a couple who are in their mid-20s. They are now living in a small town in central Florida where their family can't find them. I am thinking of you, wearing a black dress and shoes. I'm imagining you in a dark room with your hair tied back. You look so pretty with the way your face is, like a little girl with dreams. One day, you'll find yourself on a beach. The beach will be a great destination. The destination is beautiful, but you can't go there without becoming a tourist. Ode to my brain. A new song is on the radio today. It's called Love Me Like a Man on the Moon. Listen, I am writing a book about the journey to Mars. It will take me 5 minutes to complete it. I'm thinking of getting a little bit bigger. I'm thinking about going to the beach. I'm thinking, oh, this looks like the perfect place to get a tattoo of your face. The tattoo is on my left wrist. When I see it, I will look for a new job. When you see it, you will know that you are not a bad employee. The company is the only one who can afford it. A small group of billionaires who want to make the world's largest oil field. They want to build a giant asteroid that will take over the planet. I'm pretty confident they'll do it too. I'm just not certain about how long it'll take to make a decision about whether or not I want to be in a relationship with you. You should know that I'm always there, always thinking of your side of the story, always looking forward to your future without me. In my mind, you are the only person who can make me smile like a fool. Ode to the pandemic. Outbreak is a good chance to weigh your risk of being completely burnt out by people who love to live. In other words, I don't want to go back to work independently. Without a doubt, the best thing about it is pathologized into a tree that will grow from home. You can heal your heart by giving her more time to go to sleep. Soon enough, we will figure it out. In the sky is a huge picture of how this works, a negative space for your patients. The sun goes away, the sun rises, and I think it's going to get better. Ode to misery. Love's latest invention is an electric guitar. It can play with any sound you want. I'm imagining a small piece of metal in your ear. It looks like a very nice place to live. The place you went to was beautiful. It is so beautiful. I wish I could be there to witness it. But now I am in love with you. It'll take me forever to get to know your voice. You can tell me what you want me to hear, or you can just let me listen. The way I feel is nothing but a little pain. I'm just so thankful for the opportunity to meet the new guy. He was a handsome boy who had such a wonderful life. It's too bad he couldn't be you. Ode to leaving. Balance is the same as the weather. It's not a perfect metaphor. For the next month, I will be in a position to make a new calendar. I will let him go. I will become more like a group of birds in the woods, or maybe an orange that rolls down the street. Right now, I'm a little nervous. I'm sorry. I don't know what I mean. You are welcome to come visit me whenever you need to take your pulse. You are welcome to be in the woods with my voice. I will always love to see what you think I can find out here in the other half of your life. I'm not afraid of anything but a flight. Ode to divorce. By the time you get married, you'll be a millionaire with no kids. The rest is history. I'm sure you know this already. The only way to make it better is by giving up on your dreams of becoming a professional musician or a singer in a band that has never been successful. If you're interested, I recommend listening to the birds outside. They are very nice animals, but they don't like being in front of a camera. The camera doesn't do much for me, but I think it's worth the trouble. I'm a bit confused about how the film was made and how much it costs to make a good documentary, but I tried it out anyway. At the end, we were just looking at a few more details and figuring it would be worth it. At the ending, we are standing in line, waiting for an ambulance to arrive at the scene. Ode to being drunk. Tequila is the most beautiful song I've ever heard. It looks like a kid.
I had to do it.
Just say no. It looks like a kid with a new kind of government. The government will not let us go back to the days of communism, but it will let us live in a society where we can be part of a revolution. Tonight, I am a proud member of a group of young women who want to make their own decisions. My goal is to become an entrepreneur. I think I will start a small business and sell my knowledge. I know a lot about the online community of local nurseries. They are growing big leaves of money for their own gardens. I'm sure they have some other ideas to share, but they don't seem like they're worth a whole bunch of dollars. Instead, they're just a few hundred gems that I can use to make a decent game of pool. I don't know how to do a good job at hiding. I'm supposed to go to work tomorrow morning. I'm supposed to be at the office by 9. The only thing I need is a couple boxes of paper. Then, I can just put the paper in my mailbox and pick a new address. You can also send me a picture of your new cats. I promise you, I won't kill anyone. I'm just trying to be an honest person. Ode to being alone. In love with a new way of thinking, I buy myself some good coffee from a place hidden behind a mysterious tree. The tree's roots were so small, they could barely hold the weight of the water they drink. I'm trying out for a play. The play is about the death of a young woman who has lost all her possessions. She described the loss as an enormous tragedy that we quickly forgot. she finds herself in an increasingly tense relationship with a stranger who is trying to become the next president of the United States. I'm not going anywhere else today. I'm just going to stay here where the boys can't see me. Alone in my bed, I have enough room to go to sleep. I will dream of waking in a house full of cats and dogs. The cats have no sense of humor. The dogs have no idea how much they love me. They love me so much, my heart hurts like a broken glass. Ode to Tinder. I love you. The only reason I'm still here is to see you in a new room. Look at me now. I'm a woman who has never had an affair. I'm a girl who has a crush on her husband. I'm just a little bit of an idiot. Because I'm in the process of trying to find a new one to replace the old one, I can't seem to figure out where to put my hands. You know what I need. You and me and you. The whole thing will never happen. The people who are responsible for this will not be responsible for this. I'm sorry, but you can't be the reason for my death. Ode to Sex, Part 2. In a new world, we have everything we want, and we want to see what happens when we get rid of it. The problem with this system is its lack of transparency. Just say no. I'm wearing my mask and you're wearing your face. I'm not wearing a shield and you're not allowed inside my house. Because of this, you are going through some really bad times. Right now, we are just trying our best to be as patient as a person who has a strong desire to be a part of a successful solution to the world's biggest problems. We need more than one person to make it happen. Otherwise, we will lose all credibility as a country of origin. I'm touching my heart with my own personal opinion. You are not alone, but you do have a point about how the universe is expanding. The universe has expanded so much we can't even see its light anymore. The light is still there, of course, but it's still a little too dark for the picture to turn out. Anyway, I hope you're doing well today. I love you like a dog loves you. So very happy to see your face in the mirror. Ode to Boyfriends. A boyfriend is a man who loves to play the long game. He willingly takes a risk when he's in a situation. He has a lot of potential. He has a great sense of style. He has an incredible ability to make things look like the real deal. When I'm not around, he just wants to talk to me on the phone. When I'm with him, he just wants to play the piano. The music is so much better when it's not a song that I can sing. I've never heard a single thing like this before. I'm a fan of it. I'm also an amateur photographer. The first photograph I took was of a guy with a very large telescope. He was looking at the moon. The moon was in a position to be moved by a black hole. The black hole was moving away from us. We need to stop looking at the stars, expecting them to know what we're doing wrong. The sky is not going away until it's time for the world to end. By then, we will have seen more than one world. We will have more memories than we can ever remember. Ode to a Second Chance. You can get a free pass to a game of artists who make their own horrors or you can just buy a book from the local bookstore. Either way, it's worth a shot. I'm sure you will enjoy the experience of being a part of it, my first marathon. I'm currently running away from the idea of running. I'm also rushing towards you. You, sir, are a very good man to keep in mind. You're not the only guy who needs to hear my voice. You're just a man with a passion for the sport. I am challenging you to get a good look at my body. It's not like I'm a bad person. I'm just a little jealous of your hair. Mine is so long I can't even keep my fingers crossed. The trick is to keep a promise and to make sure it is not a secret. The secret is that you are a very strong candidate for the position of head coach. You'll coach the entire team that lives in my mind. Every single day, I will be in a position to begin a conversation with you. We will discuss the future like it's been a year since we met. It's actually been quite a long time coming. It's been a very busy year for the past. Here we go, I guess. Ode to a while ago. After the merge of my voice and my face, I thought it would work against me, but I was a disaster for many reasons. I will never forget the day before I spotted this new girl in her personal universe with smart hair that could change the world. If you're into something so bad it could never thrive without any problems, you don't have to worry too much. Before I die, you must take my ass down to the beach and get up the can of pamplemousse. By the way, I don't believe in looking for other types of suns. Out there is nothing but LaCroix and no place to die. A poem is a big deal, except for when it comes for me. Ode to Silence. Is a birdsong going to make me cry, or is it just a joke to me? I'm not sure if you're still at work or if you're not the only person who needs to know about the way I feel. The only reason I'm asking is because I'm a girl alone in a room with no clothes on. The room is empty of all things except my own personal space. Here's my new quote for the day. You are not a king of a man, just a man who has been around for a while. You know what? I'm just going to say what I'm thinking about the last time we went to the beach. It wasn't so bad that I didn't realize how hot you are. If you're worried about it, just check the roots of the plant I love. It's growing so fast, I'm sure it will be able to tell me all of your names for the last woman who wanted you. I'm listening in the background. I'm hearing a child. The child wants something I can't afford. Instead, I have a new idea of how to make dinner for a friend. We will probably leave the door unlocked for you. Ode to My Body, Part 2. My choice to be happy with myself is not a choice. The fact is, I'm a better man than you are. I'm just trying my hardest not to make a mistake. In the meantime, if you're looking at something that requires a bit of practice, be sure to check behind the curtain for a few more lessons on how to make a successful product. This tutorial will teach you the basics of what you should expect from your first attempt at a proper design. A simple pattern and a simple set of rules for each piece of clothing. My favorite part of it is the way you look at me. The message I got from you was to tell you to stay. Home is where the rest go. The head is a big piece of wood. The heart is very sharp. My mom has a saying that goes, if you're not a doctor, you're not a nurse. She has a point. She has a lot of things that need to be said. For example, the first time you see your daughter, you see a girl with a red dress. The second time you see her, you'll see a black skirt. And the next time you look, you'll be wearing the wrong shoes. But it's not a problem. It's only the beginning. road to getting over it. By the time you reach me, you'll be able to see a picture of all the different plants growing together in a row. It looks like a good deal, but it isn't really. It costs the same amount to buy a new car and then drive it back to the country you are from. From now on, I am only allowed to speak with the ghosts in my head. They have been working on the same project since last summer. Whenever they are done, I will let go of the old man whose name I don't want to know. He said he was going through a rough time, but I think he's just a good liar. Believe me, anyone can tell a story about a woman, but no one can sign a contract with her. Ode to an alternate reality. Show me the real one, please. The one without a doubt of my heart. The one that has a big smile, a big face, and an even bigger crush on the girl with a long beard. I love you here. I'm just leaving work right now and will be home soon. After that, we will go to the store and grab a couple of drinks. We will have a little time before we have to go to bed, so we will just look at the calendar. We will plan to see each other in person. We need to do some research on the weather first. The forecast says it's supposed to rain. The rain will come down, and then it won't be raining again till next week. I am trying out a new recipe for a chicken salad. The first thing to do is to add some fresh basil leaves. The leaves are very delicate, like a soft green yarn. I can't imagine what it would feel like to knit with you, but I would love to know.
Amazing.
That was awesome. I tried to make it like relatable to what you were trying to say.
I love some of those comments. Really well done. Yeah. Thank you. Hey.
I just didn't want to disturb copyright or anything.
Cool. I like the bird noise.
Yeah.
And cat.
The cat noise. I was trying to do like a child crying, like a baby crying type of thing.
Yes.
I was trying.
And I gotta say, chat. Best behaved I've ever seen you.
I was like, I can't take it.
There we go.
I play with my snake.
I know VJP Cat was dying to do that one. Oh man, that was
sure
cool.
Sure, an ode to snake, huh?
That was fun.
Thank you, dude.
Heck yeah.
I think your nose is stuck on my
face. Zap that guy, don't zap me.
Yeah, right.
I was wondering, so they just all waited to. Yep. To pull the I was wondering if I just couldn't hear them.
I'm astounded. You can hear this, right?
Yeah.
It's beautiful. This is high art.
High art.
Yeah,
that was so fucking cool. And I gotta ask about is biting back this on the street redeem.
A good pink guy.
We all have pink eye now, I hope. But so
I definitely do.
I gotta ask a little bit about the okay. What this is that. Get it all out, everyone. Get it all out. About the creative process. So predictive text, yes, on the phone. But okay, for one, right, you must have some really elaborate conversations for those things to be like predicted on your phone as like predictive text. But was it like, how much did you shape it is sort of what I'm wondering. Like,
so
this is what we do here. We there's a need for speed in the chat here. They gotta have it.
And you know it's all downhill from answer your question, but you know what's funny? I was really hot when the stream started, and now awesome. I'm cool. Like that airman chilled me to the bone in a good way.
Oh yeah, heck yeah. Steamed me.
It's because Theremin player is so cool. You know what I'm saying? And the theremin is a fucking amazing instrument. It's
space
a space
cello.
Yeah, it is a space cello.
Space cello, yeah.
It's a combination of the machine and your own body, right?
Yeah, it's really circuit. It's about just the way. I mean, everyone's body is different, you know. So the theremin reacts to different body shapes, and you know, and you tune the theremin, the lowest note usually to my I tune to my chest here. I'll show you. Turn out the show. But yeah, so like you just tune it, and then you tune it in your chest, and then it's really cool. It's kind of like it's really cool that it can really like react with everything around it, because even everything around it can affect the change of the pitch, you know.
So cool. So, yeah. And Athena, how did you feel about? Oh, she's gone now. She's gone forever. No, it seems like it's doing that. But how did you feel about that? You got the chance to have some theremin accompaniment. I feel like it really worked.
That was dope. Yeah, I do too. I feel like that was these poems were written to be read with a theremin.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Heck yeah.
The combination of old school art and modern technology, right? I mean, that's part of what you're doing just with on the poetry end itself, like without any of this going on. Like, it's really neat. Very cool. And you can get more of both of these things, theremin and poetry, on their streams.
Heck
go follow their streams. Go follow their channels.
I'm sure I follow you, Athena. I'm sure I follow you. I'll flash your stream.
Oh, no. I think you do follow me.
Oh, heck yeah.
I saw you follow me. And then the next day, CIVIC DM'd me. It was like, hey, do you want to do a poetry reading with a theremin? And I was like, oh, that's why that happened.
Yes.
Heck yeah. Awesome. Very cool. Very awesome.
Making connections. Here at CIVIC.
Hell yeah. Building community.
I mean, it's crazy.
Yeah.
It's just people online.
CIVIC TV.
You know? It's things you do.
The one you take to bed.
It's all very normal. It's all very normal.
But should I explain how to write a predictive text poem? Because anyone can do
please.
It. So it's a lot easier if you have an Android phone, because with the Android phone, it does save like every weird fucking thing that you write in Discord.
I've noticed that.
Yeah. And, but how I do it, I have an iPhone now. Ooh. So it started off on Android. I do adapt my process to the iPhone, which is a little less creative.
What have you done to yourself?
too much time on the internet during the pandemic, let me tell you.
Right.
But so all you do, you have to prompt it, right?
Wait,
so
there's too much time? You can do too much time on it? When is it too much time? No.
No, yeah, that's not a thing. But I choose the title, so it's always an ode, and then I pick a phrase, alternate reality, and then that kind of determines the word choice that becomes available to you. And the only time that I don't follow the predictive text, because it gives you three options, so normally I pick one of those, sometimes it starts getting really repetitive on an iPhone, so what I do in that case is I pick a letter, and then I pick one of the words that come up from there. So that's kind of how they get a little bit more shaped.
The words around. Yeah.
Pretty cool.
Cool.
Yeah. I think of myself as like the predictive text is writing it, and I am its editor. So
quick. Someone do a predictive text poem into the chat. Like, please.
That's someone. Genius. That's
what's up, Hassan Pfeffer 510? They write all their poems.
You gotta,
in
they all look like
notes.
This because they're all notes app. And then, so.
Very cool, though. Man. Yeah. And so, that's really neat. So, the theremin player, you have, like, original recordings, even.
Yeah, I do. Actually, thanks to Twitch, I bought FL Studio Producer Edition, so that was pretty cool, and I got a chance
that's
to, neat. Yeah, so I was like, you know what, I gotta produce my own. I've been doing Reverb since I was like 13. I've messed with FL Studio and other software and stuff, and I found, like, you know, FL Studio is easy for me. It's very visual for me and very, like, tactile, as we call it. It's very, like, you know, I like to press the notes on the, like, digital keyboard on the screen.
Right. Yeah.
That's how I do a lot of my stuff, and I go by ear. This note, this note.
Sorry, yay. Motherfucker, real quick.
And then, anyway, so thanks, I Dina. Just, I appreciate just, yeah, I just create, music through, FL Studio, and then I published on, Spotify. I'm really on Bandcamp. That's where I helps a lot more than Spotify, you know, so.
All the cool musicians are on Bandcamp.
Oh, for sure. It's the cool place to music. And, like, so can people find that through your channel? That could be like an easy.
Yes,
way
if you, I'm wanna... pretty sure if you go to my channel or my website, which is my artist, Theremin Player is more of my like handle online. Is it okay if I or it's Xan Zan Hughes? Yeah, okay, so I can put I'll put ZaneHughes.com in there and then.
Heck yeah!
Everyone, don't click this link. It's gonna take you to spam. It's gonna hack your computer with porn.
No,
that's right.
Actually, we want that, so click the link.
So here
more
we go.
Porn.
This is my
click
website
the
here.
Everyone there we needs go. More porn, right? Awesome. Heck yeah.
Yeah, there it is.
Yeah, there's gonna be a lot of hentai.
Theremin themed hentai is what you'll find there.
Oh my gosh.
Rule 34, right?
Oh my god, right? So I have rule commands in my chat bot, and at one point someone came in and they're like, "You need a rule 34." I didn't know the reference. I had no idea. I'm just a babe in the woods out here. But so I put in something, and I forget what, as Rule 34, and then went and checked it online. I'm like, I need to delete that command. No Rule 34. Nope. Not
oh,
happening.
My gosh.
Oh, man. It's how you learn online. You just go to places and see things. You just see it happen in front of your eyes. And so, hey, so in a little bit, it's not too long. Athena needs to take off in a little bit. And so I'm wondering if, before you take off tonight, if you might be down to take a call or two with me.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
And Theremin Player. Let's check it
out.
Cool. Let's see what kind of trouble we can get into there. And actually...
Yeah, call up.
Now we're receiving calls. There we go.
Heck yeah.
Wait. Yes. Yes? Okay. And everyone can hear this, right? I didn't do that before the show. You guys can hear
that.
Oh,
yeah.
That,
right?
I can
hear
that.
Perfect.
Cool.
Test, test. Awesome. And, you know, don't everyone call at once or anything. No. That's right. Rule 4 is no teabagging, but I prefer Rule 1, the golden rule. you can never have sex.
Your relationships.
I'm so much in love.
You know? and so, yeah. Do you watch call-in streams? Athena Sleeps In. Do you...
I think Ben Monster is the only one that I watch.
And,
I mean, other people do call in sometimes.
That was a
setup. No, I'm lying. No, the Luke Man.
Oh, cool, yeah. The Luke Man.
Yeah. That dude.
Has he
that dude's chill
to,
as hell.
Has he gotten to 100 real conversations? He was on the road to 100 real conversations.
You know, I only stopped by for about 15 minutes, but I believe he was capable of doing it, and I believe he probably did.
Yeah, right. Very cool. And I first saw Athena Sleeps in Ben Monster's channel, and then on the show, and then in the Discord, and it's fun. It's fun connecting with people that way. We were in the same raid train. Which one was it? It was one of the interactive AV raid trains.
Oh, yeah. Well, did you know I'm actually a co-organizer of that?
Oh,
actually,
that's really cool.
Yeah.
And you were in with...
You've been in a couple, I think.
No, yeah. you're in with a Graceful Bard.
You know? Yeah, we did. We did a stream. Then Twitch throttled me, and I could not fix it. But there is a crystal clear recording of that collaboration on my channel. If anybody wants to check it out,
that's awesome. Heck yeah. Good news. So. Yeah, I'd actually really like to check that out. I didn't realize that. I was there for that, and it's like, yeah, it's frustrating when that stuff happens. Like the first time we all tried to get together.
Well, like,
on
the I don't
show.
Know. If- I don't know if that Zoltan Snarf is still watching. He helps me out with a lot of tech, and we like looked into it the next day, and his conclusion as tech support was that Twitch fucked us over. Yeah. So
that sounds about
which
right.
Which makes me feel better about my competency as a streamer, but
I was trying to, like, you know, diagnose my issues with my past system, and it's such a head fuck when you get into, like, okay, there is my processor, my graphics card, the encoder running in OBS, which is sending to the internets through my ISP over my network, my network
a series
gear.
Of tubes.
It goes into the tubes. It does the exchange, the handoff. It makes it somehow to Twitch Central, you know, in those tubes. Then, yeah. Anyway,
and
it's
then
like
Jeff
so
Bezos
many steps
farts
away.
And right. It breaks.
And then he hands us down bits, and it's like mana from heaven. You know, he just rains bits on us. It's like, here you go, you peasants. Here's some pennies. Have fun. Get on the internet. Stay on the internet. So like in the end, I feel like there, like my sort of diagnosis on my last system was like there were 3 to 4 separate issues causing problems for me, and like that's it just was a tear down. Yeah. Just had to get a whole new thing in here. Now it's a quality production. It's only quality.
It's very
quality.
Yeah.
Best quality in
CIVIC
town.
TV, the one you take to bed with you.
But Santa Huel said best episode of the show in the chat during your performance.
Oh, really? That's so nice. Thank you.
That includes Santa Huel's being on the show. So he's saying best episode of the show that he's guest starred on. So that's high praise. It's really cool.
Ooh.
I really am into, like, having some art around here for a change. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Instead of just, you know, this sort of thing.
Eating is normal. Eating is sane. And eating is something that your body requires.
See, that's the thing, though. I think that should intermingle with the art. I think that's good. I think that's what people want. That's what I want. I think that's what the chat wants. So,
what do you think,
chat? Mix it all together. Make a weird soup.
Yes, we're in the soup now. We're in the soup together. Santa Huel says, I'm great. That's it. That's all he said. No, he said, I'm great, but I never prepare. This is just stuff that they had lying around, right? I mean, you just got theremin for days over there, right?
Yeah.
And,
that was some theremin for days. Thank you for the stamina.
Hell yeah. And Athena just has word stuff out, like, everywhere.
Can't stop it.
Right?
Yeah, I thought I was too spooky for a second, and I was like, I thought I was too spooky for the vibe. Because I love, like, you know, 60s sci-fi films and stuff, and less kind of scary stuff. I don't know, but it's kind of cool.
I mean,
it's kind
I
of
feel like the theremin is kind of spooky, like, by
you're
nature.
Right. That's true.
You get some real beautiful tones out of it, too. And I don't know if we have mentioned this. I don't think we have on stream. Theremin Player does live soundtracks to movies.
Yeah.
On stream.
Oh, yeah.
And the
Whoa,
range
that's
is
cool.
Really apparent.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's and, on Thursdays. And yeah, thank you.
Yeah, Thursdays.
Yeah.
Check
yeah, Thursday.
Out.
And sometimes Saturdays, too, for the more scary stuff. But
cool.
Thursday is mostly for, like, in the mild scary and Saturdays are for the scary nights, you know, so, yeah.
That's
heck yeah.
We generally.
What's the scariest movie you've ever done?
Well, we watched Horror Express. That's a really scary one too.
Yeah, that's fucking horrifying.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, with the red eyes and stuff. Oh my gosh,
yeah.
It's like.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's definitely one of the scariest. But
played that last year on a Halloween. Yeah.
Nice.
That's a quality one.
Did you say Polar Express?
No.
Horror Express. Those being like the CGI with Tom Hanks. They criticized that movie of being super uncanny valley, and I was like, yeah, that's the scariest one.
No. It's a 70s film.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh man, I just blanked on the name of the
studio.
That is a
scary one.
The
Polar Express is scary.
But
Horror Express. Okay, that makes more sense.
Peter Cushing.
Will you do the Tom Hanks Polar Express? Though I would like to see
that. Yeah.
Maybe like in 80 years in the copyrights and public domain or something.
Oh my god! Right.
Like, 80 years old, just like theremin 80 to the Polar Express.
Where's the James Franco theremin record?
That's true. You know that guy has 5 master's degrees in fine art.
That's amazing.
Actually, wait. Oh.
Green Goblin is who you're talking about. Has
look at this shit. Is it going to be backwards? It's back. Okay, it's not backwards for me. This book is called Straight James, Gay James. It's a book of poetry he wrote. It's the worst shit I've ever seen.
Amazing.
I've been like cutting it up on stream, but he has 5 master's degrees in fine art, 2 in fiction, 2 in poetry, and 1 in visual art or something like that.
So that's his foreword to his own book, is him talking about his degrees?
No, that's the end in his bio.
Oh, well, still.
And everybody who blurbed the book, they're all very respectable poets that he paid tens of thousands of dollars to study with. So, you know.
I pay for respect as well. That's how I generally get respect, is through money. You know, throwing it around. Like, big shot, throwing around money.
Yep.
But, and so, yeah. James Franco is also a creep. I don't know if you knew this, but you know.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
But his younger brother, Dave Franco, is married to Allison Brie, and they have a very wholesome relationship, which I'm sure his publicist loves to play up.
Well, that's nice. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm related to
he
someone.
He also has an older brother. Sorry, I know too much about the Franco stuff. He's an older brother who's not very famous, but he's a sculptor and he's like a little talented. Like, cool. He's also, they're all kind of mediocre. But one of them married Allison Brie, so good for him.
James Franco came in as a topic in the chat, and you had the book.
Like, Spaps knew the book was sitting there.
Yeah, right. I'm sure he's sorry, and he learned his lesson. Santa Hules thinks of the best in people. That's the first thing he goes to. It's like, you know. People are worthy of redemption, all that sort of thing, you know, like it's no big deal. But
didn't he keep messaging underage girls on Instagram though?
And,
like how many times did he have to do it before he learned his lesson?
Yeah.
like
Anthony Weiner.
Oh god,
no, just keep going, just double down on that. But there's also something like James Franco was teaching an acting workshop, and like part of the acting workshop was simulated sex scenes, you know, like which does come up in acting. But I guess he did it in a very uncomfortable way for the female members of the class. Yeah.
That's sad. That's very sad.
Funky stuff. You know?
Show business. Yeah, show business.
But you know, Athena.
Yeah.
You've been amazing.
Thank you so much for having me.
Transcendent.
I have to get up at the crack of dawn and make beef for my cat. And then
oh my god, right?
I just sound like such an asshole. I'm going to like a charity event for rescue animals.
Day starts, so, 5 a.m., you know, making beef for my cat.
It was,
for my sickly orphan cat, and then go help more orphan animals, because that's the type of person I am. No, it's just the way it goes.
Yeah, it was really cool to do a theremin and poetry. It was so an honor. Yeah. I appreciate that. Yeah,
cool. It was awesome.
Yeah.
I'm really glad we got to do that. This is my first poetry reading, like, for real on Twitch. Like, I've read poems on my stream. But this is the first, like, felt like a real poetry reading. So that
was cool.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah, that was
real
awesome.
Real poetry here at Civic TV. You know, I had to throw it in there. I'm somehow involved. No.
Like, Civic TV.
That's going to be cool to go back to.
Yeah, you brought us all together.
Yeah,
Look at you building community.
Yay.
It's beautiful.
Awesome. Thanks, Athena. And I can't...
Zapped me. Actually, wait a second.
Wait, is she going to... Is this... Oh! Zapped herself. Dang.
Oh.
Hey, thank you for the support, too. That's awesome. Appreciate it.
All right.
And
off I go.
Yes.
Oh, wait. Were you going to say one more thing? You said, and
I'm going to play you out. No. Actually,
okay.
Theremin player, you mind playing her out? And I will hit the button.
Yeah. Make me go out the lake. Suction into space.
Thank you so much. It's been awesome. Very good.
Bye.
Later.
Bye.
Wait, a soda, right?
Should I just
go.
Okay, bye.
There we go. All right.
I don't know. I don't know.
It happens. I mean, you know.
Yep.
Be safe out there, Athena. Out there in the wild world of cats.
Cats.
Yeah, you know, cats. What's that all about? Don't you work with animals? Isn't that right? No.
Me? Oh, no, but I'd like to.
Awesome. Never mind.
Yeah. Yeah. It's okay. Oh. It's no worries.
There we go.
I remember this video you showed.
Is that
yeah?
Is that how
I
you
was,
tune?
I was watching that.
Yeah.
Yeah. I can show you how to tune the theremin if you like. If you have time for that, if you want to do that or not, I don't know.
Let's do it.
But okay. So basically, go ahead.
No, like go for it. Go in.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So I'm going to turn the theremin on. Now, as you can tell, maybe that there's no really low pitches over here. It's kind of too high in pitches. So what I usually do is I turn the theremin, my right hand, put on my chest, and put the lowest note.
And
when it's
by
lowest
the way,
note, like that. It's
there
kinda,
are
yeah.
receivers on the theremin, right? How are you manipulating?
Yeah.
It? So it's,
yeah, so there's electromagnetic field, and you just your hand, anybody walking by can mess it up. That's why it's really important to do personal space when you're on a gig. And so, basically, you just now you can make finger positions too, and you can. Like, I'm nervous. Sorry, I'm nervous.
All
sorry.
Good.
No, okay.
Hey, if
you know, it's science
stuff.
If you feel
nervous, just look at the baby and all of your cares
will
go away.
Okay.
Like, right?
I gotcha.
Isn't
yeah,
that?
Yeah, that's a cute baby.
It's transcendent right there.
Yeah.
I
so
used
it's
that
a, it's
word
a lo-
earlier,
lo-
now it's stuck in my brain. And, so, like, yeah, is there like a resource you use to get into theremin playing, or is it
I'm self-taught. I never had a teacher, or there's videos on YouTube that help too, but I've always been like on my own journey and my own kind of thing, and just kind of learning about myself past 6 years. So
Hass and Pfeffer asks, how will they eat that whole burger? Well, this this kid has been chewing on this burger for the past like 3 months at least, so I don't think it's really gonna get there. I think it just sort of like chews it up and then thinks about it and then just keeps going. I mean, he never stops. He's a persistent little tyke there, you know, and we applaud you, meat baby. It's just something that happens here in space. Babies eat burgers and whales fly by.
Whales fly.
So, like, there's a
heck yeah.
I can already, you know, like, it doesn't take much to see the comparison between whale song and theremin music, right? Like,
yeah, I mean, definitely the theremin can mimic a whale song for sure. I have it on my Bandcamp. I have a couple of meditation tracks that are recorded, and yeah, and they're like kind of cool, like ambient, much of ambient reverb, and it's kind of, and even sometimes stereo. So, like, you know, you might hear the whale go this way, and then this way, you know, kind of going around you and stuff. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
That's awesome. Stereo theremin can recordings. Yeah. That's fucking cool. Hell yeah.
Yeah.
And it's like space cello for a space whale.
Yeah. I think that should be my emote, shouldn't it? That should be my emote now.
You should do a live soundtrack to Star Trek IV, The Voyage Home.
No. Heck yeah.
But like that'd you were cool. saying, right? Like, you use movies in the public domain generally.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah,
like,
I'm very, yes. Yes. Yeah.
What's that all about? I mean, no, like, you don't want to get in trouble or something? Like, what is
it? I don't know. I don't want to get in trouble, and I value my community. And I don't want to get, like, in trouble and lose it, like, have a strike, you know? And,
yeah.
And it's, then kind of damage it, you know, the community and stuff.
It's annoying. It's...
Yeah.
It's yeah. rough. But, you know, we bounce back. You know, like, there's, like, little things that have been the most annoying about getting suspended in the past. I mentioned, actually, before the stream when we were connected about follower emotes. I can't ever change my follower emotes because I've lost instant upload eligibility. And if I take away one of those follower emotes, I'll never get it back. So we're locked in for the long run with those. But Santa Hules loves strikes. He's horny for crime. Yep. I don't know. I must have something here that relates to that.
I'm a man. In your spare time, you are a man.
Somehow relates to that. and, you know. Just throwing them all out there. See what sticks.
Yeah. Heck yeah.
Yeah, but so, like, besides all that, when you... get suspended, it unlinks all of your services, like stream elements, whether you have Streamlabs or any of those third-party, you know, add-ons. All of those links get broken. You have to redo them all. What's up, Hedgehog Party?
Yes.
Thanks for hanging out. Hi. We got Theremin Player. This is Theremin Player.
Yeah. Okay.
What's up, Theremin Player?
What's up?
And, so then... like, I don't know, just so many things get broken, you have to redo it all. For that time that you are suspended, like, some people wouldn't think about this. I didn't at first. You can't even access your account, so you can't see who you're all following. Like, you can't get on Twitch and watch because, like, I mean, you can make another account, but you don't have any of your followed channels. It's really annoying.
How long were you suspended for?
Stop doing it. Jeffy B. so I let's see, first time was for a week, then I switched to another channel, got suspended for 2 days and then 5 days, and then more recently both of my channels got suspended for 5 days. And yeah, and that's about it.
Dang.
But you know, we soldier on. Come at me, bro. No, please don't. Please don't report me. it's annoying. It's a thing. But yeah, so we were talking a little bit before the stream on the call, right? How long have you been streaming?
Yeah.
How long has your stream journey been?
So I started streaming when I was 13. Ever since I was like, and of course I couldn't broadcast because I wasn't like 13 yet. Before I was, I liked like radio stations and like, you know, having like a podcast, live podcast. So it was kind of 2011, 2012. Then I at the 13 years old, so I made a YouNow account back in, that's a whole different platform. But YouNow was kind of popular. Yeah, and then you know, I found Twitch more promising because the affiliate program, which, you know, it's kind of cool, and then Twitch has been my go-to for streaming ever since, really. And it's about 10 years, yeah. But the interest for radio and broadcast was like, I was like 11 or 12 and stuff like that. So
yeah. Feel that for sure. I was always into TV. TV. Yeah. But yeah, I've been very into it. My brother set up a pirate radio antenna in our house.
Oh my gosh.
I was already 18 or something like that.
Yeah.
But we had a pirate radio station that broadcast in a radius of about 4 blocks. So if you were right in our part of town, you could catch our channel.
Yeah.
And it was fun. I don't know. We would actually broadcast vinyl. We hooked up the record player to it, and we'd have all vinyl shows like in the neighborhood. Yeah.
That's really cool. I like that.
But we had no name for that station, actually, Surf Bats. I know that, like, what the hell? Like, why not just name it? But yeah, we were just fucking around. We have many channels now, many names. We all have special names in the Videodrome. There's a really cool community radio station that I keep meaning to get involved in here in Kansas City area. It's all, you know, volunteer run, donation driven. And you can find it anywhere online. It's really cool programming.
Yeah.
Do a lot of funk, soul, blues, jump and jive, and Zydeco. just a ton of different stuff. There's actually like a program that comes on at a weird time of night on the weekend that's all modular synth, even.
Oh, that's really cool. I've always wanted to get into that. It's crazy. It's complicated and expensive. So
it is.
But I've always wanted to get into the Moog unit, like the old school. This is a site called synthesizers.com, and basically they're not as much as Moog, and they're still expensive, but they're like off-brand Moog unit, and I've always wanted to buy that and have a whole rack and stuff and play places and stuff.
You know, for full modular synth, like Eurorack synth, there's a program, you know, VCV Rack?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, but I've streamed that before, yeah.
Oh, cool. Yeah, I didn't realize that. That's awesome. Yeah,
it's fun. People like it. It's cool.
Been learning it more recently, actually. Yeah. You know, I have some synth and all that, but, like, we don't have modular synth here. We have a semi-modular Korg MS-20, right,
that, where you can mini?
Patch things.
Is it the full size? I have one too. Yeah.
Oh, cool. Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Synth, yeah. Brothers in synth. No.
Yeah.
And so I haven't done the full modular thing in person, but I'm learning it and getting on VCV Rack, and I guess that might be a thing at some point in the future.
Definitely good when somebody is to spend like all this, like spending spree on just a bunch of gear, and like it definitely just, it's kind of, you know, be careful, you know, like the CV, I'm trying to say the VCC, yeah, the rack, the software you're talking about is really good for those who want to try it out. Really have that impact in the price of all the stuff you need, so.
All in the virtual realm. Hey,
hi, Bobby.
Bobby Highwater says, I know that Theremin player guy. Thanks for hanging out with us. Yeah. I know that Theremin player guy too. And you all could know him better if you follow him.
Oh, yeah.
Constant shill. Right. And so I did miss Hassan Pfeffer asking, did it ever get to be like, pump up the volume and driving around in a Jeep broadcasting as they chased you? I wish it did get to that point, but no. funny thing about pirate radio stations, they're hard to find. Like, you know, you're just somewhere broadcasting on a frequency. We picked one that, like, we weren't competing with any other radio station, you know? Like,
yeah, yeah.
But have you ever seen, by any chance, the show People Just Do Nothing?
No.
It's a, like, BBC show. And,
oh, yeah, I love BBC.
Yeah, it was these guys who have a pirate radio station in England, and they primarily play garage.
Yeah,
they play garage music. Garage. And, like, so it's a bunch of ratchet, like, shitty fucking rap songs that they self-produce and, like, rap right into the transmitter. I mean, like, you know, they do live rap shows, and, like, it's a really ridiculous show that is really fun. I say check it out. CIVIC TV says check it out. Do it. but, yeah, man. I asked this before, right?
Mm-hmm.
But what would you normally be doing on a Friday night?
Oh, well, today, today at least, I had an event that I did at an art gallery.
Right.
What? So that's awesome. Kind of, you know,
so much art this thing today.
It was a little art gallery, and people loved it. People were walking by the theremin, like, you know, asking questions, which I was happy to answer. And I was a little nervous. Sorry. Yeah, if you want to know how the theremin works, you know, I can't really explain it. I'm a little bit nervous, but it's on the internet. You can find it. Yeah, okay. And then people loved it.
Things are on the internet? No, you can find things, information online. What's up, Juan? And so that's super cool.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it was cool.
I miss art. I used to do art.
Oh yeah.
is this art? All right. Is this art? Art? Did we find the art yet? No.
Is this art?
yeah. So my voice is back to normal, right?
yeah.
So yes, I did a gallery show one time. Mm-hmm. I've done some different art happenings and doings, but I have found that streaming on Twitch is the most artistically fulfilling thing I've done online.
Mm-hmm.
Off of years and years of being a weird guy on the internet who does things. some of the art stuff I've done on Twitch has been just tops. Top of the pile. And I love it. I love the art community. We met through musicians and such cool artists on Twitch. And you know Jimmy. You know Coincidence.
Yes, I know Jimmy, yeah.
Yeah. So
yeah, he's cool.
He was the second interview I did on stream.
Yeah.
It was with Coincidence Machine. And so really glad to get you on here. Finally, after like a false start and everything, like
I think it like a lot of hype even more. I think you know, so yeah.
Good night, Santa. Santa's been hanging out. Appreciate you.
See you, Santa.
I just got this to say.
Because I'm not the Santa, you know. I'm Bizarro Santa from the Lectura Dimension.
It's just your normal thing that happens.
Why? It is traumatizing.
Well, that means I've done my job. If I traumatize a guest, that means it's a good show. Like, right? But so we are the one you take to bed with you.
Yeah, my nightmares.
Yes, right.
CIVIC TV, the one you take to bed with you.
Providing nightmares for all the people. I dare someone to call in. What's up, Nick? I dare you. dare you. How's it going, Nick? Oh, so I just got a new illustration from Nick Caesar. Nick, the biohaunted doll. Fucking cool as hell. Some art of the channel. And I'm going to see if I can pull it up in a second here. We can probably find that on the internet. It's really fun. What are some of the streams, like, not, well, whether it's specific streamers or not, I'm curious, like, what are some of the streams, like, stream types you like to watch on Twitch? When you're twatching, Twitch watching.
Yeah. I mean, I like to watch a lot of, loops sometimes, you know, like, people that do loops, like, you know, Bardic and Preparation. No, Bardic, Graceful Bard, and also Bardic.
All the Bardics.
Yeah, all the Bardics. Yeah. Yeah, they're all cool, and everybody does. Yeah, it's great. And then I sometimes like to get, like, watch some gaming, you know, watch some. I usually go the first person I see, really. I don't have any kind of gaming channels I really watch. But I like to watch gaming because it's different, you know. I'm so used to music. I want to take a little break. And then it helps me actually kind of think of ideas better when I have a gaming stream and I watch it. And, you know, so yeah.
I'm with it.
Yeah.
Because so one thing is, like, I genuinely believe that there shouldn't be so many divisions between streamers or humans. But mm-hmm. It's like,
yeah,
some people are like, oh, I only watch art, I only watch music streams, insert thing here. But it's like, mm-hmm. So then there's like this level of, like, I don't know, elitism, I guess you could say, in some people's attitudes towards gaming streams. Like, oh, it's just a gaming stream. Well, it's like the gamers were the ones who's like, this platform was started for gamers, but the tools mm-hmm. that developed to, like, enable people to stream on this platform were all geared at gamers. If it wasn't for, like, gamers doing their thing online with people, with communities, mm-hmm. and showing it off to people at home, we wouldn't have Twitch, we wouldn't have Stream Elements, we wouldn't have all the integrated things that go mm-hmm. into the platform.
Yeah.
And the interest just wouldn't be there. So fuck yeah, gamers. Like, that's my thing. We got a call. Caller, welcome to the internet. How are you doing? Happy Friday.
Happy Friday. I was dared.
Nick, you took
that's
the
like
dare.
Being summoned for a ghost doll.
That's right. We have a biohaunted doll here in this. Well, it's over there just outside of the studio. And I accessed its powers to summon Nick the biohaunted doll. What is up?
I'm always listening in that weird peeping Tom void of, bewildered spirits or whatever.
Yes.
Hey, good to see you, Theremin. I really dig your stream.
Thank you, I appreciate that.
And it reminded me, when I lived in San Francisco, we had the Castro Theater, and there was an orchestra that would rise up. And
that's awesome.
So when you're playing along to the films and everything, it's just like, I was like, oh, that's really kind of, like, it made me sort of, like, nostalgic for that. And everything. And then, you know, I'm also, like, a cinephile because I know, you know, CIVIC.
What? So, mm-hmm. You like movies? What's that all about?
What? Movies? Yeah. No. I read books.
How gauche.
I read a lot of books.
So yeah, did you know I lived in San Francisco? Have we chatted about that? Yeah, Castro is super cool.
No, but I mean, you went to my wife's high school, so that's kind of weird.
Yeah, there's this weird level of synchronicity, or like I don't know, pure coincidence, the coincidence machine. No, but
definitely, we're just separated at birth somehow.
Yep. Yep.
Like, absolutely. You're the Arnold Schwarzenegger, I'm the Danny DeVito.
That's right. Twins.
Twins.
Who would be the leftovers? Would I be the leftovers? No, you know how they describe Danny DeVito.
The DeVito's the leftovers.
Yeah.
I'm definitely the street cat of the group.
So you're saying I'm an Arnold.
You would be the guy who they would put in the tuxedo, and then yes. I would be the guy who they had put in the basket.
Amazing.
And you're like, this is my friend. This is my, my brother, Belial. Yes. He likes hot dogs.
Belial. Dude, so you were talking about, like, the orchestra pit and, like, being, you know, nostalgic for, like, the Castro and all that. But also, mm-hmm. we chatted before on a call about the silent movie theater museum in... In Fremont, California.
Downtown historic Niles.
Yes, Niles. Niles Canyon in downtown Niles. I've been there. I volunteered there at one point, and they do, I don't know if they do this all the time, but when I was there, they were doing live music to silent film that they were projecting. And did you, like, is that a regular occurrence at the theater? Do they always have live scores?
It mixes up. One of the people who run the theater is actually a really good friend of mine. And like a while back, we had an art show in the theater. And I was I was going to make it all like William Castle and everything and stuff like that. But it all depends on the event. It's a really good place to, especially for independent filmmakers, to screen their films. They have equipment and histories and everything going from, like, you know, Jim Henson's workshop to... like Chaplin to they just recently acquired a whole bunch of special effects that someone just had in their basement, and
the goat Samuel Z. Arkoff.
Yeah, like, if you love film, definitely check it out, because you can, like, they repair and they recreate, like, all the old equipment. So if you are, like, a really big into film and everything, it's definitely worth a peep.
Duchins, thanks for hanging out. And so, Thurman Player, have you ever seen a silent film in theater? It's a cool experience.
Yes, I think I was, like, 9. It might have been Charlie Chaplin. I can't remember, but...
neat.
But yeah, it was a silent film. It was played with an orchestra. You know, that people were there making music. So it's kind of like what I do now. But yeah, it's really very inspiring. Very inspiring.
Very cool.
Oh, that's cool. How did you get involved in the orchestra and that? Because I mean that. I have a friend out here who he does a lot of shows and everything. Does a lot of plays, and he's always in the orchestra, the pit, and everything. It's just like. It's always like this, like, kind of wild, I don't know, I don't want to say they're like pack of strays, but everyone has like an interesting history of like how they sort of ended up there. From like his background, like he was in a heavy metal band, and then he ended up playing bass for like Guys and Dolls and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So it's really neat.
Awesome.
Yeah, I mean, I was I was 9 at the time, so I didn't play theremin, but I knew where you're coming from. It was very inspiring. I remember, and I go back there in Indianapolis. There's like a nice art museum that has like a theater, and yeah, I know it'd be really cool to go back to those events and watch those performances with the whole orchestra. It's really I like it. It's really cool.
Hell yeah.
Oh, definitely. Because, I mean, like, theremin, like, because I grew up in, like, you know, Creature Features, all the old sci-fi horror. And theremin was just, like, such a staple to my childhood and everything. Yeah. It's just, like, yeah, it's so great, you know? It's, like...
yeah.
It's also, like, one of these things where it's, like, it's such a cool instrument, but I always feel like it's just underrated or underappreciated.
Yes.
You know, because it's like,
yeah, definitely. It definitely is. And people have heard it, but they, like, when I go to a place, like, for instance, for the art gallery, you know, I was like, hey, I play a theremin. And I said, the instrument that you hear in the sci-fi movies.
Yeah, that's how
and,
you
and that's how you, yeah, it's like, what's a theremin? You know, you've heard it. Yeah. They've heard it, but they never really, like, know what it's called. And it's kind of spelled weird, too. If you might think it's T-H-E-R-A-M-I-N, but it's actually, like there, like over there. It's like T-H-E-R-E-M-I-N. So, yeah, it's especially
days of, like, Claire Rockmore and Exotica, and you had...
Yeah.
You had all these great... It was this wonderful, like, hotbed of creativity, you know, with like, Exotica, because it's kind of like... You had all this sort of like jazzy lounge music with sound effects.
Yeah.
You know, you had like the birds, you had the tropical things going on, you had the theremin. But it kind of, it was like one of the things I heard Juno Reactor talk about, where when they created music that they were trying to create, like, they're trying to world build or create their own play or their own,
people like environment. Had more space in their lives for it. It feels like, right? Like there was like a little bit more breathing room for like that type of music to exist in people's lives, right? Like it's like,
yeah,
definitely. Oh, sorry.
We miss it.
No good.
Space.
Space. Billions space. And billions of years.
Yeah.
That's right.
And I think for me, it's like I improvise everything, unless it's like a song like Over the Rainbow or something. But I love improvising. And I like jazz. I like classical. Like if I could be educated in all of that, I would. If you were expensive, but you know, if you were educated in that, and I started out just like with the theremin, just figuring out my myself. No teacher. I mean, nothing really. A mentor would be Claire Rockmore or Samuel J. Hoppin, Dr. Samuel J. Hoppin. He plays the old like more. Fortunately, I got into that, and that's what led me to the movies on Twitch, and then that's what led me to the whole, like, you know, spookiness and stuff. So, yeah.
What's up, Fart Stimulator? Hi. that's super cool. Heck yeah.
Yeah.
I just showed up here one day and thought, like, you know, I better do something if I'm going to be on stream. Maybe I'll steal this set. No. Check this out. Look at that. What? Whoa. That's an example of Nick's artwork, his artistic expression.
Thank you.
That's awesome.
Does it remind you of anyone?
Yeah, your next theremin album, you know, hit me up.
Yeah.
CD cover.
Yeah, that'd be
hey,
cool.
That's really cool. And
I'll definitely, you know, I'll definitely catch eyes and everything. And yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it reminds me of, like, kind of like the punk, kind of like the, it kind of reminds me of, like, art and, like punk stuff. Like, it's very, like, it's kind of strange, but it's, like, it's cool. Like, it's, like, why is the guy green? But he's really cool. Like, it's really cool. Yeah. I like that a lot. Yeah, it has, like, that kind of, like, obscure, kind of cool, weird guy on a TV.
Well, like, what like does that
mean, you know? So, yeah, I like it a lot.
I think it's just, like, back in the day, like, I used to be a punk rocker, and it was all kind of like,
I've seen pictures.
Kind of like very similar, like, how you'd find the theremin or whatever is, like, you have the top 40 radio, you know, or you have AM, FM. And then you're
just
always
like,
kind of, like,
is
digging
Nick's
for something
right there. Nick,
more.
Nick the Bio-Haunted Doll. Yep. Sorry.
Yeah, but I'm actually playing... Oh, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, and it's just like kind of like experimentation that, and I think that's kind of like the heart of jazz is experimentation and expression, you know, a lot of guys, a lot of the big artists, they're all self-taught as well. And I mean, they have records. And I think the whole reason, you know, they stood out is because they did something different, you know, they played around and they made it their own versus, you know, like going by sheet music. You know, it's like I was doing this one art show and this guy went to, I forget, it was just like some really pricey art school. But he's like, I wish I could do the stuff that you can do because you're free to do it. I can't because I have all these laws and I have all these restrictions and I have all these things that sort of bind me. And the only way that I could do it is this, because if I deviate off of it, then everything unravels, you know? And it's just like...
That's definitely how I learned. Was just like, you know, just I'm kind of a self-taught person, and I've had teachers, and I never had a really good experience. Oh, they're good experience, but never had a good progress. But like that, what you're talking about exactly. It's like, definitely. I see what you're talking about there.
You gotta be the uncarved block, you know, full of potential.
Yeah. Well, not like that. Not I mean, it was just kind of like didn't Hendrix didn't he practice on the broom? You know, it's just I also think if you have it in you, it's just in you, you know, and
exactly
it's kind of like one of the things where like I've been professional arts since 2006, and it's like I always tell people, it's just like you have to like be in it, like genuinely in it, because you'll get highs and lows, and if you can't like tether through them, you know, it's just like
get it in it like this, Dad. Oh, so
Nick? It's like I know so many like really talented people who aren't talented outside of their rooms because they're like burned once, and you know, or because they were dealing with something different and nobody got it, and so they're like, well, nobody gets it, so I'm just gonna, you know,
there's
a lot of like
kinda,
outsider music, you know, like that's it's just like there's all this stuff that's out there. It's just everyone needs to like find their tribes, you know.
Yeah.
I think that's like one of the coolest things about Twitch is like it makes that sort of like a little bit easier.
I agree. And I was actually just going to say something semi-related is just like I find, you know, I don't pretend to think that like what has happened in my life is a good like blueprint for anyone else's life. Right. But it's like as you go on and you keep trying the same thing over and over and maybe it doesn't like go where you want it to, it doesn't meet your expectations, or you're not like living up to what you think your potential is, some people will get bitter and let that sort of stomp on their artistic expression, if you know what I mean. Like, but what I have tried my hardest to do is pivot. You do something a little bit different, you explore a new avenue. Like,
that's very true.
Going from video production to Twitch streaming, it's just like it's just over there, but it's a lot different. And I used to slave away on edits, just like edit and edit in a room alone for hours and hours and hours. And then sometimes people would watch the video, you know, but here
totally.
I am. I know someone's watching, you know, like, and it's instant content creation. It's not instant. This took a little while to cobble together, but
But it's also like one of those weird timeline things because like the longer, at least in my experience, the longer that I've done it, like I've had people contact me like in like 10-year intervals. Of like, oh, hey, I remember you used to draw. Could you draw me something like this? And it's like, I haven't heard from you in like 10 years. Yeah. It's like you're in the back of their head. And they're like, and they're just continuing on where they left off. But you're like, we're in the future now. Like, where's this gap? And I don't know.
It's like,
I wanted to say.
Yeah. Oh, go for it. Boom.
I was just saying, like, when you said about like, you know, the people like when I you know get discouraged by the progress. I had a really good progress recently. Back in the year or two ago, I would think now I think like that that the people that come into my stream to see the theremin, you know, that's an experience. So yeah, the viewers, you know, they everything counts because like you said earlier, you know, people it can be like five people, and that still means that five people saw the theremin and are aware of the theremin, or have seen it, you know, and that's what really matters. It's all that matters, you know. Like if it's a bad day or has like, you know, hardly anybody comes in the stream sometimes, you know, that's the people that came, that's what matters, because they've seen the theremin. That's the awareness I'm trying to bring to the theremin, is that reason. So but yeah, five people, 10 people, 1,000 people, whatever, like it's like everything is counts in this spreading awareness. So
everything counts in large amounts, you know?
But not only that, I think it's like I think the other thing too is the you know, the uphill battle. It's not for people who give up very easy. You know, it's just like, and it is like one of the things, like I've done art shows where nobody's shown up, you know, and then I've also done, like, I've had a piece of my art in Scream 4, you know, and it's like, I don't know. It was like one of these things where a while back I took a break from social media and I realized it's like I have like all these followers and likes and everything. But like, what does all that mean? Like, what's the value in that if like nobody gives a shit about like what I'm doing, you know? And that's where I just kind of like turn the tables around or switch things around. Like, I only give a shit about the people who give a shit about me.
That usually means that what you're doing might. Is good, but it might need a little bit of change, you know.
Yeah.
It can be like a centimeter. It can be, and like, you know, whatever you know, a little. I always say on stream, especially on streams, 1% sorry, 1% better each stream. That's what I say.
Fuck
when
yes.
When I you know, a new title, Rush, a new title like method or like strategy, you know, putting numbers in the first couple of characters of the Twitch title helps a lot too, and then trying to figure out, you know, that's how I do it. And I try to, you know, if I get stumbled or depressed or mental health kills me for a second, I just, you know, step back and like, what can I do that's going to change and like for the good, you know, and then I do it, you know, 1%, yeah, 1%. So yeah.
And just
yeah, yeah, that's true. Jushin's, that's true as well. Always listen to your audience. Yeah,
that's right. Wait, who said that? Did somebody in this channel say that?
Jushin,
yeah,
what
yeah,
audience?
Yes, yes.
What?
I'm
just joking. Yet.
Oh my god! I'm so gullible.
I agree, Duchens. And it's like in anything that we're talking about, there's a performative aspect in what we do, including like illustration, including the art. It's not art. Uh-huh. It's audience isn't viewing it, right? Or I mean, that's debatable. But point is, we do this for an audience, and I'm fine if. Say one person enjoys what I do mm-hmm. that day, but the other aspect of it is the conversations that happen, like connecting with people. And mm-hmm. so what I've talked to with musicians a lot is like, there's this crazy aspect of Twitch where when you're doing a show, you're on a stage and you're doing it at people. They're not mm-hmm. like talking back to you, like from the audience, like, wow, that was really good what you did there with that song.
Yeah,
like, you know, or maybe you could play that again for me, please. Like, no, you know? But so there's this awesome like interactiveness to this here that we're doing.
I want to say that makes the pants a clock for the kind words there. Thank you, appreciate that. Yeah, but yeah, heck yeah, thank you.
Hell yeah, more than a noisemaker. What?
Well, some people are very, kind of don't want it to be just a noisemaker, which I go both ways. I like the sounds of the sci-fi and scary stuff, but I also like more of the classical and or jazz, or I even try metal sometimes with theremin, and that hasn't done very much, too. So,
that's great.
It's pretty cool, too. Yeah, yeah. Thank
you. yeah. And
I think that's like one of the other things that's really kind of like empowering about like being self-taught and putting things back in your own hands, kind of, is you make your own journey, you know. It's like the journey is the destination after all. And I remember like in the beginning, like I had no idea what the hell I was doing, and I just did everything trial and error. Because that's, I was like, well, you know, the only thing I had to go by of like how to survive as an artist is like either Andy Warhol or the movie Basquiat, you know?
Yeah.
And as I went
great
through
movie.
It and everything, I just realized that super great movie, but I realized that like, there's just not one path. There's like 60,000 million paths, and applying the model that was the 1980s economy with the 2000 economy, it's very different. You know, but we're all adapting and adaptable, and like, I don't know, like one of the things I really dug about like Twitch is like, it just kind of adapts with me. Like, you know, I still have no idea what the fuck I'm doing with it, but I'm having fun with it. You know, I made a biohaunted doll for it.
I've seen the pictures, but I want to see it in action. When are we going to see it in action?
We're going to see it soon. The problem is all the chemicals need to dry on the box because the
Chemicals? Yeah. What? Wait.
I love when someone's describing their Twitch stream and they're like, the chemicals have to dry first. Like,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, that's funny. I like that. It's cool.
So it started like I went to the thrift store and I found this doll for like a couple bucks. It's this like crocheted little doll that's really kind of spooky and everything. It's like the whole back is like moth eaten. And so then I was just like, oh, this is cool. I'll just put like the webcam on this doll, maybe like kick the table every now and again, but you know, that'll be my stream. And then I saw this other part where I was like, oh, I can make it a helmet. So that way it's tapped into the stream like a, you know, some sort of pseudo bullshit science fiction 1950s ghost science.
Video.
And then
headset.
It started getting bigger and bigger. And then I started adding tentacles to it. And now it needs to dry.
Yeah.
But it should be ready.
Yes.
Dude. It needs another day to dry, but it should be ready probably by Monday.
I could really see, like, you said add a theremin, but I could really see, like, expanding on, like, props for it and stuff like that. You know, like, theremin player said, like, you know, ratchet it up every stream, 1% improvement every stream. Just add a little detail here and there, you know, and just, like, really, really see how far you can take this biohaunted doll thing.
Is this scary? You see this? This is the original.
Oh.
This is an original. The original one from the 50s and 60s. But it's pretty.
Amazing.
I've used this in tons of my films. I used that little monkey. I brought it to school once too. People freaked out. Yeah, talking about. Yeah. It's a family. Family. You know.
Oh, cool.
Thing.
Nice.
So, yeah, it's been around the family for a long time.
Take very good care of those things.
That's
because
awesome.
Those things are
Heck
like.
Yeah.
They're rare as hell now.
Yeah.
Because everyone wants spooky monkeys.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Who doesn't want a spooky monkey in their life?
Yeah, I
like,
made some
like
short
no
films.
Situation is less improved by a spooky monkey.
Yeah.
Taco Dog says, I don't. You can have mine.
I have a collection of 17 ventriloquist dummies.
Send spooky
and,
monkeys to this address.
Yes. Right? Yes.
Like, but, we need them here.
Yes.
I use one in my streams. Do you really, VJP Cat? Because I know you have.
Oh, that's awesome.
Like, what? Sound making devices, I guess you could say.
Oh, yeah.
PCAT has so many cool toys.
Heck yeah.
Back when I was in high school,
I want to visit PCAT, but then I would be like, oh, God
I
damn, I don't want to steal anything.
Yeah, when I was in high school, I made short films, and it was one of the was the monkey, and like I did a scene where it was on the table, and it was off. I recorded for like 5 seconds, and then I turned it on, and went, shh, you know? And it was so creepy, because in the film, like, it just turned on by itself, but very, like, you know, kind of like, you know, it was creepy as heck, but I loved it. People thought that was crazy. I had a whole, like, I was in TV production, and we had a nice studio, and I would, like, use the cameras and my, you know, and it was really cool. I used my phone, actually. It was my phone, and it was an app with, like, old 8mm black and white kind of filter, and it was awesome. Yeah, it was cool. It was really cool. It was awesome. Yeah, it was fun.
I've been known to make a short film or two.
My dream is there's a series called Tokyo Horror Videos, and they're kind of like a Where's Waldo of ghosts for adults, or at least like, or just like really easily frightened kids or whatever. But the whole series.
Can we go back to that description just real quick? The Where's Waldo. What was it you said?
It's Tokyo Horror Videos.
Yes.
Or Tokyo Care Videos. And,
Dude King, no need to apologize. That's what we're here for. No.
it's like, you know how Paranormal Activity is? Like, you're staring at a wall for 3 hours, and you're like, well, like, when's the ghost going to show up? And then jump scare, it's like a piece of paper that fell off, you know? It was just like, oh, Well, this just, like, gets rid of the plot, the story, everything you hate, and just gets to the ghost part. And it's, but it's so repetitive, like no, Dora the Explorer, book, where it's like, did you see? And it's like, they go, and they show you the ghost, the bad CGI ghost, and then they get a close-up of it, and they're like, did you see the ghost?
Man.
It's hilarious, but fun at the same time.
I think you would really like Nuke's Top 5. Have you ever checked that out on YouTube?
I haven't.
No.
Nuke's Top 5 is like a massive YouTube account, millions of views on each video, and every one of them is named something along the lines of top 10 scary videos that will make your mama cry, that sort of thing. And so it is edited together like haunting ghost videos from the internet. So he just gets submissions from people or finds them himself, does like a top 10, top 5 reel for the moment. And like, but the repetitiveness is really what made me think of it, right? Is like, he'll play a section of the video through and he's narrating the whole thing, this guy. And he's like, wait, did you see it? And it goes back and plays the video again really slowly. And then it's like
really beats you over the head with it.
It's like right there, and it zooms up again on it. It's all pixelated. It's like right there, silhouette in the window, like, you know, like
Super Mario was the ghost the whole time.
It's pretty fantastic. And, you know, every once in a while, there is like a video that they include that sort of like is a noodle scratcher. You're sort of just like, oh, that's weird. Why was that baby talking to the empty room, like, while
because babies are crazy.
Yeah, it's like while her mom recorded it.
Have you looked at babies?
I have been known to look at babies, if you know what I'm talking. No, like,
that's
sometimes
crazy.
Well, no, yeah, babies are weird. What's that all about? You know?
Yeah, I mean, look at that sociopath.
Yeah. Just like
the dinosaur on the shirt says, like, I like to eat meat, meaning I'll eat dogs, cats, people, hamburgers.
You know, we don't shame here.
Eating is normal. Eating is sane, and eating is something that your body requires.
Oh my God, racist is about.
It's a Nazi baby, so it fits right in.
There you go. Nazi babies love Big Macs.
That's right. Yeah, so Stokostos on meditation on art. It's like, where does the art come in? This is sort of how I think about it, is it's not just the object, the music, the sound, the piece. The art happens in the translation between the artist, the object, and the viewer. Right, that's the complete arc of art.
Mm-hmm.
It's art once a viewer or an audience has absorbed it, and the art happens inside of them, inside of the audience. Right, you have an intention as an artist, you put something out, and then it's received in an entirely different way. Right,
yeah, because people will project their own experiences onto it,
absolutely.
And it no longer becomes mine, it becomes like whomever is like checking it out and everything. Like, I had someone go to me and they're like, the thing you painted attacked me like when I was a 5-year-old kid. I was like, that's funny, I just made it last week. Like, you know, like shit like that, where it's just like, wow, that's cool. And what I like about it is it just becomes like a virus, because like if I do an art show, the more people that see it, the more it lives in their heads, and as they walk out, it grows on into them, you know. It's just like,
and yeah.
Would you say it gets all up in your guts, as Duchin?
It gets
suggests?
All up in them guts.
Yeah, I've even heard that. So like, some artists will like write lyrics that make no sense, and then like somebody will perceive that as something personal. Like, it's kind of cool. It's like you can write. There's some artists, like, you know, like famous artists who write songs about like nothing, but then also for some reason sometimes it can connect you to something that you experienced. That's pretty
interesting.
Yeah, I love
that.
That's pretty cool.
Some of that is like, yeah, some of the I guess sort of more interpretive song lyrics are the ones that I tend to connect with, you know? Like if someone has like a very specific narrative in their song about a girl they met one summer, it's like that's not really what I relate to, you know? So that's David Bowie or like Beck or something, like sort of like free association, like, yeah, that's the stuff that I really connect with. Yeah,
I've also learned that I've often gave a lot of musicians too much credit.
Oh, sure.
I've met a few, and then I was like, I thought you're like a mastermind behind the keyboard and everything like that.
You
and
thought they
like,
were doing
dude,
that to
like,
you. No, but really they were just
doing it. It was like Keanu Reeves. It was like every other word was dude. And I was like, oh, in my head, I had imagined this like mad scientist, like, you know, I don't know, living in the basement somewhere, like, you know, creating this weird music. And then I met him and was like, hey,
mad
dude.
Scientist.
Yes.
Got drugs.
Love it. And you know, it's just a thing you do. You just bang it out. I also really appreciate people who sort of take that that sort of like free association approach, or however you want to put it, to like the actual musical composition rather than just the lyrics, you know what I mean? Like people who can like really bring different genres and weird forms together into like sort of a collage of music. I listen to some weird stuff basically.
Yeah.
But you know,
like Witch House, Negative Land, have Throbbing Gristle, you have Skinny Puppy, you have and then you also have like Wax Taylor, and then you have like all the mashups, and then you have like
mashups.
Everything now from the Avalanches to Run the Jewels, it's mashups.
And a lot of really talented use of really talented like manipulation of samples, some of that stuff, it's like amazing to me. What's up?
Oh, totally.
Dante Boom Shanka.
Hey Dante.
How's it going, Dante? Look at who we got here, Dante.
Hi.
What sucks is I found out these bands like Black Moth, Super Rainbow, and their other project, Tobacco. And then it's like, oh yeah, that's 10 years ago when they're out. Just like,
I know. Where does
I'm always
the time
late to
go?
The party. Like I always get like really into like a genre of music, and then they're like, oh yeah, that band broke up like 20 years ago.
Yeah.
And it becomes like a Scooby-Doo episode. They just like talk to them in past tense. They're like, they still haunt around the, you know, the music shack here and there, playing the old tunes.
I've written a book on
the
it, actually.
Ghost musicians.
Intercorporeal maltransference.
But, you know, sometimes it's like that. Sometimes it also takes like the filter of time to figure out what you're supposed to listen to. Now, it's not like, you know, not like listening to top 40 hits, I mean, but it's like you find out what like fits your taste, like movies, you know, like maybe I missed a movie like when it came out, but now it gets associated with these different things, whether it's online or in conversations. People talk to you and recommend something based on your interests, and it's like, oh wow, that I completely missed that. I watch movies every day, but I missed that one somehow, and then you go back and watch, right?
It's also amazingly in the marketing, because all of our lives revolve around products and consumerism.
Yeah.
And nostalgia, you know, it's like
nostalgia.
Like, I was like, I don't...
Mellow Canuck
Civic TV.
I see the
one you take to bed with you.
I see it. Buffalo Bill, baby. Can we call him the Buffalo Bill Nazi Beef Baby? Is that...
Sure.
Oh, my God.
All right. Yeah, so do you think we're at peak nostalgia yet? Are we peaking? Is that what's happening?
I think we're tapering
Take
off because the phone codes are now starting to decline.
That's right. They're starting. They're in decline. Yes. But yeah, I don't know. I think you might be right. I think we might be on the other side of the peak, at least for now. But like, yeah.
I think the flip side of it, though, is now going, moving beyond collecting and now becoming like kind of more of an art form of the, like, the mixtapes and everything like that. Like all the videotapes where you go through and you mine all the images and or all the segments and everything. And like everyone from like Everything's Terrible, Found Footage Festival, and all the people that inspired to dig up and find like all this other stuff. So all this great stuff is coming to the surface, which is like super fantastic.
It is. I love it. Nick, you mind if I get this other call?
Get the other call.
Goodbye. Love you, Nick. We missed it anyway. No. Hey, call back.
Okie dokie, daddy. I'll talk to you later.
It's been great, Nick. Call back. Thank you for the call. Absolutely.
Bye.
Call back.
Hey, see you later.
Very good call. That was a very good call.
That was fun. That was good talking about expression and lyrics.
It was, yeah. And I see, Stokastos also with thoughts.
Oh, yeah, I call him Stosh. Yeah. So it's like, Stosh. I can't resist him.
I know.
Yeah.
Words and stuff, sometimes they get caught in my mouth and they don't come out no good.
Oh, yeah.
We got a voicemail, actually. I think we can listen to that on stream.
Gosh.
But Fort90's hanging out and says, there's currently a cold war among certain parties trying to fight over the lost and weird footage for their mixed products. Right. Like, that... It happens, right? Hey, caller, welcome to the internet. How are you doing?
Hello.
Doing great. This is Bad Phone Chad. How are we all doing tonight?
Bad Phone Chad is phoning. We got a phone call from Bad Phone Chad in the stream, online, internet, cybers.
How's it going? Like,
what's up, Jaime?
Yeah.
Jaime 13080 says Boor Gur. That's right.
That's right.
That's a unique one. Yeah, Boor, that's a unique one. That's
for sure. We're finding new modes of expression.
That's something a theremin. Yeah, that's something a theremin takes really good power in, is Boor Gur.
Right. Boor Gur stream. So what do you think about video mixtapes, Bad Phone Chad? Who owns
them? I have one. I have one, and I think through your Discord that I will promote. You've seen some follies I had because I went to Goodwill to buy a VHS player.
Yep, right. Hell yeah.
And
we do VHS.
I brought it home
sometimes. Yeah.
I know, and my better half, like, I felt like I was a champion. Like, I brought pelts home that were antiques and, like, the best.
Some pelts,
you know, like, here's some beauty.
I love that.
I plugged the damn thing in, and of course it didn't power on. And
yep,
I have a video drum tape of Twin Peaks, so I've been really excited to check it out. No, Video Drone is a creator. He's them. I have no idea who they are. Not to, you know.
You have you have something that looks a little bit like this.
I bet you have it.
Right?
Yes, look at this. I do. I've not seen it yet. It's sitting 22 feet away from me, and it makes me sad. I have not seen it yet. What color
look at this
is yours?
Beautiful product. I was just going to show that off, actually.
What? Open it up. What color is yours? I have a certain specific. Oh, mine's different.
Right?
I have the blood.
Three versions,
kind of,
I think, of it. And,
Video Drone. Video Drone.
All red curtain in there.
You know, Video Drone. Video Drone. Yeah.
Video Drone TV, everyone. Yep. We do Video Drone here. And, so check it out. But, yeah, that's super cool that you got that, too.
I'm still waiting to see it, though. So that's my... I think I answered the question actually successfully, but no, I've had a few beers and just chilling. It's Friday night.
Happy Friday. Happy Friday to us all.
I have a busy weekend, so.
Hey, Civic. I got to go. It's kind of late here. I appreciate you having me. Thank you for all being here and chilling.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, I'm going to go to bed.
It's been amazing.
Yeah, it has been amazing. I appreciate it. Yeah.
On that happy Friday note, it's like probably Saturday by now over there.
No, yeah, like, it's Saturday here.
I
got to witness it, and thank you, Theremin player. Just as
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you so much, dude.
All the kind words. All right. I'm going to follow you. I'll see you next time.
A quick link to follow you. It's very easy to follow you below.
Yeah. Hell yeah. Heck yeah.
And
all right.
Have a great night, dude.
You too. You have a great
we'll do it
night
again
with your
sometime.
Calls and everything. Yes,
heck
of course.
Yeah.
Yes, please. And message DM me.
Hell yeah.
All right. See you later. Peace out.
Positivity. Woo. That's cool.
Yes. Woo. Positivity. What's that all about?
I don't know. It's a challenge. It's an attempt.
Yeah.
It's what I hope we're all working to do. So.
Yeah. You know, there are many ends of this Twitch thing we do, but there's like this great drive towards positivity. Like, I guess, like, the community building aspect of it, the, like, community moderating aspect of it.
You've shown me that a little bit, too, because I'm kind of over boisterous at sometimes, and people kind of hate me and get mad because I'm hard of hearing, I think. But then my style of, like,
no one hates Ben Funchin.
Well, yeah, no, I have people. But my style of the avenue of like a call in or something is just be brave, and then you're in control to yes and then we yes and as well. You know, that's one thing I
control.
Think when people...
No, I don't control anything except on my little control panel. That's where I no.
it's a nice handoff. I mean, there's that thing. So
lost you a little bit there.
But when people want to call in and they're afraid to, one thing of advice I always tell people is just to call in and say you want to talk about something. So.
Yeah, I mean, not gonna bite your head off, you know. It's just the thing you do.
So what is poltergeist for you?
Poltergeist is everything.
It's
one of my favorite movies.
It's on your shirt.
Absolutely, top movie for me.
Wow, and really?
Yeah, completely. And
I have to figure that out. I'm gonna watch it silently and challenge you, like, with you can defend every minute of it or
every second. No. Yes, every minute of it. silently judging, just watch it based on that. Like, now that I've hyped it up, think like how can
right.
I tear it down from its position of height?
Yeah.
Like that's how you need to watch.
mine I think is Westworld.
Awesome. The set, yeah, we watched that on.
So flawed.
Yeah.
Because or flawed because it's so flawed, but it's so like neat. But I don't know.
There maybe is a movie that is like. Technically unflawed, but then you get into like the realm of like Citizen Kane and shit, and I don't know, that's still there's still technical flaws in that film, but it's like my point is like, you know, Citizen Kane is a fantastic piece of film, it's a immortal piece of art, but is it fucking entertaining to watch?
it does lose at time, but
yeah.
Then when it loses, my attention when a movie loses me, I get mad because I'm trying to focus on what direction and what they were dealing with, you know, as far as everything. And that's the neat part about everything as well. So.
Yeah, totally know what you mean though. And I like that Taco Dog said, I fell asleep watching that. I haven't finished it. Yeah. I've watched it more than I care to admit, but yeah. Oh, but so, by the way, going back to Poltergeist, right?
Yes.
Absolutely on its face, like in a non-ironic way, completely fucking awesome movie from a technical standpoint, a character standpoint, all that good stuff.
Yeah.
But there's a memory, I mean, more than one, but like our memories of these things from childhood, that's often what like endears us to like any piece of art or movie or whatever. But,
which makes me frustrated as a creator or as wanting to ever promise to do anything. Do you see that as well?
Yeah. I know what you mean, though. Like, so, like, I mean, hey, take it as a challenge, right?
Well, I do, but I feel like I'm wasting people's time with that, you know.
Well, this is Civic TV. You watch because you have nothing better to do. No, I'm just joking.
See,
but,
that's a ploy, but.
I was saying, though, sorry, Poltergeist, right? I have this memory of, like, being scared shitless by the clown doll scene.
Just the tree. Just the tree. The first time
tree
I
is pretty freaky, right?
I mean, that's like 2 minutes and 18 seconds in, and I was done. I was done.
Yeah.
With just the tree, because I had a tree outside my house like that, and, you know, 1980s, I'm being honest.
Yeah.
We didn't... Well, back in my day, it was like window was open. That was your repense for heat in, you know, in May, in July.
So,
And noises happen.
There's a fun bit of trivia about that, is the clown doll that I mentioned and the tree were things put in by Steven Spielberg because those were two fears he had as a kid. The tree outside of his house and clowns. The face picking is immortal, but it's just like, so there was something about that clown doll as a kid that fucked me up, and the scene where it attacks the girl. What I remember from being a kid is like being scared shitless watching that with my parents, right?
You just absolutely hot dang yes anded where when you said when your parents zerged, and I call a zerg like a jump scare, you know, when your parents ever like fucking like flipped it out, you know, that was amazing to see, because it's like dad's scared of that, mommy's scared of that. Hot dang, you know, that was,
you know,
important.
You know what got my,
you know,
dad
fight or flight.
In real life, my dad, bugs would get my dad. It's like he was one of those guys where, like, you know, a fucking spider crawls around in the room and stop everything. Gotta kill this spider.
My dad has always been social programs that affect him for the positive.
Oh, well,
he does not like those. Yeah.
I love that. Threatened by the general presence of social programs that could be beneficial to him as a human. Like
that's his love to not understand and need to eradicate is everything that I slightly tell him, that if one person got 1/17th less a boat, he's okay. Or if the banks, we just told them not to risk our own existence in monetary pretends less, like 2%, we're golden, like, for a time. But I don't know if I should talk about that. That's tough to think
we're
about.
Here for a hard hitting political
civic
commentary, you know? We learn
it's
lessons
that
about
not really, because I didn't blame anyone except we all let it happen.
I mean,
it's a game.
I'm okay if you blame people. But no, really, though, this is not... Anyway, you get the idea. You get the gag. No. But,
I like it. I like gags.
I'm a man.
Gags are fun.
In your spare time, you are a man.
Great guests. Uh-huh. Amazing show. How's the computer going? Has it been holding up?
It's been awesome. I'm really excited
about
it.
Sweet.
Hollow Gravy's cool. In the chat. What's up, Hollow? So I was on last week, and there was an issue that I suspected the whole time had nothing to do with my system or my connection. It's just you just can't win. OBS gets weird on you.
OBS.
Black Sun Massacre. I had dreams that my pet xenomorph slept on my bedroom ceiling. I was born in violence. That's pretty dope.
You should write that down. You should write that down. And if you die in the next 7 years, that should be your tombstone.
Yes.
What you just said, I don't... Will you please repeat that?
This, oh, well, it's in the chat. It's from Black Sun Massacre. I had dreams that my pet xenomorph slept on my bedroom ceiling. Ah. I was born in violence.
Yeah, that's a cool mug. That's a cool fucking mug.
Or a mug.
That's a mug in November. Come November, around Thanksgiving, if randomly you have a mug for sale through like Teespring or something like that, it's just
like
something where it might buy us stuff for Civic TV in a nice way. And you know what's kind of weird is we might even
Civic
truthfully
TV,
be
the one you take to bed with you.
Hey, you yes. know what? I had dreams that my pet xenomorph slept on my bedroom ceiling. I was born in violence. That needs to be in a mug.
Send free mugs text. To this address.
You can sell it around Thanksgiving time. $17. I'll buy it. And we cannot talk about it or think about it from this moment forward. I'm going to pretend that this call didn't happen. But I'm going to buy 3 of them if it happens.
I have 2 t-shirts available.
Oh.
For sale.
I never knew that.
For purchase.
Dang it.
In fact, I meant to ask Nick if he received his t-shirt. But the next one on the to-do list is a mug. I'm going to have a little Civic TV mug for cool. the people out there.
Yeah. The one channel I adore, I've asked if there was a turkey leg that just showed up on a soup spin. And I've adored that if that would be a photo on a mug. I've asked like 19 times and it's just, it makes me mad. I want it.
Info channel, everyone. Info channel.
Never heard of it.
Yes. Nick said, I sent you a video via IG, and I haven't checked that, obviously, but it sounds like Nick got their t-shirt. Fuck yeah.
Whoa, cool. Well,
Nick
Civic,
got pink eye.
Anything
from
the you
shirt.
Need to ask me? I don't know. I'm usually overbearing, but...
What is the worst thing you've ever done with your phone? Bad phone, Chad. Worst thing.
I would get mad and throw my phone at, like, my... truck windshield.
Oh jeez.
I had a job where I was a delivery guy driving a UPS sized truck. And people would just do stuff in front of your vehicle that was, you're 11 feet in the air and you're looking down at the world and just the angst that you had to feel for them as well when you'd be like, don't do it. Don't do it. Don't be in front of me, you know? And it was just, there was one time where I said two letters and I will not repeat them. So if anyone wants
track
to go
track them down,
back,
find them now. Docs.
Yeah. I was in a place and it was a place where like, it's not like when you see the busiest intersection in Japan, but that's it's near that, and I'm driving a giant vehicle. And it was one person walked by. I was eating a sandwich, and I threw it at the windshield.
You threw the sandwich?
I threw the
or
sandwich
the phone.
At the windshield. No. Both. Both.
Both.
Instant both. Little package lunchable kind of things with little chunks of cheese and chunks of ham and 4 or 5 crackers.
Is she supermarket sweep-esque? Is she?
No, that was that's Susan Powder, and she wrote about food, nutrition, and such, and also had a bunch of videos.
Have you invited her to the show yet? And did we get in an argument about that before? Or?
No, but we can argue about it now. But no,
I'm actually pretty chill tonight.
Stop
the
insanity.
I know I can be.
No, you're always chill, but you know.
I should cheer some bits because I have bits. I'm going to hit C-H-E-E-R and I'm going to do like 44. Do I have 44? Yes, I do.
So Bad Phone Chad got to the 1,000 bits emote with intervals of like 44 and 24 and 88 and shit. You too can get to 1,000 bits cheer in very small increments.
Yep. It's fun.
And yeah, Fortnite, nice. There's some interesting pictures of Susan Powder at this day and age. Yep. Absolutely.
Oh boy.
We should all increase the insanity, not stop it. No. Yes. No. Yes. Yeah.
Banana split.
So for you, CIVIC.
Yes. Me.
What would be like, now don't be afraid to like kind of be honest about this. Like if you got $5,000, holy crap, what would it be kind of like impactful for you?
So do you mean $5,000, for like your all, channel. Like doing this, like, and it's all at once?
Yeah.
I mean, I could pay myself back for the new computer I bought, but no. That's a great question, and let me stall for time by saying, it's a great question. No.
Well, I want to see this rad. I want to see the rad skiing thing, and I'll tap it for myself.
Fantastic. I love that.
And I can hang up. I could hang up, or you can ask me another question, I guess. I don't know.
What
root for me for Wednesday though. Did I mention that?
What was this?
Root for me Wednesday?
Wednesday, what's up Wednesday? That's my
I'm
question.
Going for my dream job.
Fuck interview. Yeah, do it.
First interview.
Get that job.
Dream job.
Get it.
My dream job.
Send out dream job vibes for Chad on Wednesday. Hump day, it's happening hump
please.
Day.
Yep. I'm not joking. I need vibe. But I don't.
Send vibes to Bad Phone Chad by way of Civic TV.
I wanna vibe them back to people who give me vibes though. More important. That's a great thing. Community stuff, you know? Just hanging out together, listening to each other, just being silly.
No big deal.
No yeah. Fucking big deal. I had to pay $80 for my internet, you know? That's dumb.
Yeah, it is.
I'll do it. I installed internet. I installed internet when I was a little boy. I used to climb cable poles and stuff, but, you know.
It sucks how much... We're reliant on like these giant companies providing internet service to our house that we have no like influence over. Like, but that's always the way, isn't it? Like, please give me good internet in my neighborhood. Finally, please. No. Okay. Fine. But,
yeah. And then like my state had like $7 billion in like COVID bucks that like people wouldn't let people spend. And then the debt limit behooskery just said that like it that has to just go back away, which is fine too. You know, it's like I don't care and I can't help all of you be mad at everything. I just want to fucking hang out and be cool and rock and roll. Can we all just beg to do that? And Civic TV, hot dang, dude, you do that. And this
Thanks,
is
man.
What... Hey, it's true.
We're just hanging out, no it's big true. Deal. Just guys on the internet talking and hanging out, you know?
Yeah, time's going to go by. You're going to introduce people to stuff. Hopefully people are smiling more and high-fiving. Being cool, you know? Take another stick of butter if you need to and just put it where you got to do it. Butter is the best. I'm mentioning butter just because it's one of those top 19 things. So,
top 19.
Maybe that's another topic for another night. I don't
Rice
know.
Rice cakes.
Yeah. yes, it's been a very good call. Bad
well, I want to recommend one thing more.
What's that? What you got?
The movie
what
The Visitor.
Got? Okay.
The movie The Visitor.
Yeah.
And then hot dang, I will take a day off of work. I will lock myself in a universal chair and I may even get a cell phone camera or a camera or a chamera
camera
to info cham jam and we should watch Tiptoes.
Tiptoes. I gotta see that movie. What a mess.
I think. Fucking Tiptoes. I think.
Someone was very adamant in the Discord.
You know, okay. Have you seen the documentary about that aristocrat's joke?
No.
Oh well, it's just one of those things where it's like, it's a thing where
like hard hitting political commentary.
No, they show 40 people's reactions to it, you know, and it's like, oh yeah, blah blah blah. One of those things.
I'm into blah blah blah, blah blah blah. Well, blah blah blah, blah blah.
I think a documentary about Tiptoes, without ever even showing it. I don't know. There's something there as well. You know, I mean,
it's
it'll
be your opus.
It's a waste to just burn it. It's more to like invite people to see it, and showing the people watching it.
That's I love that. Yeah, just
I just saw the trailer.
A movie about people watching a movie, into it.
No, before they do, just being like, are you ready for this? And then it's like, here you go. It's Tiptoes.
Into it. Well, hey, bad phone Chad.
Yes. Yes.
Break a leg on that interview.
Ah. Yes. And if I don't get it, that's fine. I feel confidence for being available to go to the interview. And work sucks. And always fight to get what you earn. And don't ever tell anyone that you're not worth what value you know you are giving the company. Pro worker. Be good.
Put that.
Be good to yourselves.
Yeah.
Yep.
Hey. Be excellent to each other and have
party on,
very
dudes.
Good weekend. Yeah. Party on.
Station. All right. Bye.
Later, bad phone chat. Hell yeah. I think that skier, this is already from a little while ago in the chat. I think that skier does have one leg, and I've tried to decide that for myself. I think it's a one-legged skier holding something as balance. Right? Isn't that what it seems like? It's like he's holding, like, to keep himself balanced on the skis. It's the K-12, baby. Are you K-12? We get K-12 here.
Fucking K-12. Civic TV. Home of the K-12.
It's not K-11. It's K-12. Anyway. yep. A short film where Willem Dafoe is informed that there's an entire channel in a Discord community devoted to his dong. I feel like that wouldn't impress him. I feel like the legend of Willem Dafoe's dong is as long as his dong. No, I'm sure there's been many discussions on many internet forums about Willem Dafoe's dick. Just saying. You know? I need an adult to show me where to pee. That seems problematic somehow. Who else has a big dick in Hollywood? Anyone?
Show business.
Yeah, the Fassbender. James Woods, biggest hog of them all. Let me tell you. I bet Danny DeVito packs a punch. You know what I'm saying? Frank. Little Frank. I love that people are just, let's chat more about this big dong stuff. Oliver Martinez. I don't know. I probably do know that actor. I just don't know by name. Milton Berle, dude. John Hamm, though, is he all just a voice, or does you think he's packing heat? John Hamburger. Kurtwood Smith, don't care if it's true or not. You know, I think we should turn this into its own Discord channel. Wild rumors about celebrity peens. Let's all argue in text format about who has the giantest peen in Hollywood. Or I guess just in show business. But I want that. I want that for all of us.
I'm a man.
In your spare time, you are Tom a man.
Tom and his Jones. Tom's got a Jones. He's jonesing for something. Oh my god. Love it. Stellar commentary in the chat, as always. We're elevating the game here. Yeah. I mean, let's watch something real quick while I make a quick adjustment. I'm going to throw one at you for free just to reorient myself here.
On the street! On the street! I think there's something stuck on my feet! Life is great! I feel great! I could eat
no
a whole
specific
pound
topic,
of hay!
Really.
Hello, Mr. Sidewalk! How'd you get so long? Do you mind being under me? As I sing this happy song!
We just talked.
On the street!
Chat with guys
on the street!
On the internet.
Where I am,
sometimes, you know, there's a non-guy around.
On the street.
Sometimes there's, you know, the other type of human or some type of. Anyway, sometimes there's a non-guy around. It happens. I think Brack is on the street. I'm not sure though. And so, folks, I don't know if there are more words that I haven't said. I mean, I think we've said it all. Penis is a word. Art. I said art more than once tonight. And I love that for the show. Like, pussy, there's a word. Hey. Thanks for the word. This is fine. Inconceivable! That's a word. we're going to do this. We're going to raid out. It's that time of night. And I love our guests, everyone. Go follow Theremin Player. Go follow Athena Sleeps In. And, you know, never stop watching Twitch no matter what happens. The world's ending. Things are on fire. Buildings crashing down. Just get on Twitch. You know? It's what you gotta do. We're gonna raid. And I appreciate you all. Thanks for being here. I know, you know, I kid and I say, because you have nothing better to do, but all of you have better things to do. And you choose to spend your time here, and I appreciate that. You can take me to bed with you. There's always the VOD, right? Just play it over and over and over and over and over. Thank you, Jaime. I appreciate it. And, are we going to synth out of here? No, I don't think we're going to synth. I don't think there's time. We're raiding out, everyone. It's really happening. Remember this.
Don't listen to them. Come back. Come on. Come back. Come back to me. Don't go away. Don't go away. Come on. Come back. Come back. Come back. Come back.
And hey, Nick. I appreciate that. Send your zaps, your bits, your tapes, and all that good stuff to Reptilian LLC, P.O. Box 214, Independence, Missouri 64051. And hey, give us a call sometime. Leave us a voicemail. That's a thing. Have a good night, everyone. Happy Friday. Later.